Hello, welcome to the audio slide presentation of my article, Evolution, Empowerment, and Emancipation, How Societies Climb the Freedom Ladder. The article is published in the journal World Development. I'm Christian Welzel, the author. The article provides evidence for arguments outlined in much greater detail in my award-winning monograph, Freedom Rising, published recently at Cambridge University Press. The basic story is about human empowerment, which is an inherently emancipatory process because it gives people control over their own lives and their society's agendas. Human empowerment is a pervasive process. It bridges all three spheres of societal existence, intertwining first a society's existential conditions, second, its cultural orientations, and third, its institutional formats. Here we see what indicators are used to represent these three things within the overarching polarity between human disempowerment and human empowerment. Existential conditions are represented by action resources, which include material means, learned skills, and connective media. Cultural orientations are represented by emancipative values, which support freedom of choice and equality of opportunities. Institutional formats are represented by civic entitlements, which include personal autonomy rights and political participation rights. The bottom line is that less widespread action resources, less widely shared emancipative values, and less well-enacted and respected civic entitlements constitute human disempowerment. The opposite on each of these three conditions constitutes human empowerment. Each of the three elements of human empowerment touches in its own way on the status of freedoms in a society. Action resources enhance the utility of freedoms in an objective sense. Emancipative values enhance the subjective value that people attach to their freedoms. And civic entitlements give people the guarantee to exercise their freedoms safely. The three aspects of freedoms are held together by two vital linkages. First, the utility value linkage leads people to value freedoms to the extent that these freedoms have utility in mastering life. Second, the value claims linkage urges people to make claims for the freedoms that they value. Because of these two vital linkages, the utility, the value, and the guarantee of freedoms built on each other in a way that creates the freedom ladder. This slide summarizes data from almost 100 societies around the globe that represent more than 90% of the world population. The trends shown cover the last 50 years. The left-hand diagram shows the coevolution of people's action resources and their emancipative values. The right-hand diagram shows the coevolution of their emancipative values and civic entitlements. The synchronization of the moves is impressive in both pictures, and it is clear that the global trend over the last 50 years has been towards increasing human empowerment in each of its three manifestations. Here we see a surprisingly strong correlation between a geoclimatic feature that I call the cool water condition and a region's level of development evident in people's action resources. The cool water condition is a combination of cold temperatures throughout the year with continuous precipitation across the season. What is significant about this condition is that it gives ordinary people a rude existential autonomy, that is, easy and equal access to safe water resources. The cool water condition prevails in high latitudes and in coastal proximity, and it goes together with a lower prevalence of diseases, which enhances reproductive autonomy. Reproductive autonomy eases the transition away from maximizing the size of the population towards maximizing its skill level, which is vital to kick off the human empowerment process. Today, all cool water areas of the globe are advanced in human empowerment. Recently, the cool water condition shows a diminishing impact paralleled by an increase in global integration. Globalization eases the diffusion of technologies that overcome the disadvantage of hot and dry areas, such as water procurement, air conditioning, and vaccination. For further details, read Freedom Rising, Chapter 11. Thank you.